Hernandez. We're at Seaview Rotary Wings.
Wings, yeah.
Okay, I got it right this time. And we're in New York.
New York, yeah.
And you're not from New York, though.
No. I was actually born in Dominican Republic. Lived in New York for a few years. Went to Florida for like a year and a half. And now I'm back here for school.
Okay. Well, then you better, we'll go right into that because you actually have a career from the country that you're in.
Yes.
And now you are taking some classes because that's what you have to do to be able to practice your trade.
Yeah.
It's not really a trade. You're actually a doctor.
Yeah, a dentist, yeah.
Well, that's still a doctor.
Same thing.
In this country, it's a doctor.
Well, a doctor, yeah.
Okay. So go ahead. You're a dentist.
Yes.
And you're taking some classes in order to obtain your dentistry license in the United States,
mm-hmm,
right?
That's correct.
Okay. And you fly helicopters. Great. So I first met Leslie down in, I didn't meet you, but I saw your videos when you used to fly over the water. It looked like in the backyard.
The front of my apartment, the front entrance had like a lake.
Okay.
Yeah, I lost two helicopters there actually.
Oh, okay. But he flies very well, and we'll have a couple videos posted because we are here. What I usually ask people is, what helicopter, because you have a line, you've flown pretty much all the line helicopters, what's your kind of go-to helicopter and why?
I would say the 700L, that's my biggest helicopter right now. It's just more stable. I feel you could see it more, and for me, I feel I could control it more because of that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And which ones do you have besides the 700?
I have a 450L, 550, the 700L, and I just got the 600XN.
Okay. So you have the new 600XN.
Yes.
And we saw that fly today, and as I said, I'll have the video up. What would you recommend to someone that's beginning, what steps to take if they want to start flying helicopters?
Well, like everybody has said, I would encourage people to get a simulator.
Okay.
Most important thing I would say. I started with a 450. I feel that's a perfect size because it doesn't scare you. You could buy parts and you don't feel like you're wasting a lot of money or spending a lot of money. First of all, I would say try to build it yourself. Learn how the mechanics work, okay, because sometimes that holds people back, you know, not knowing how to fix the helicopter. So other than flying and simming, also learn how to build them and how everything works.
So that's a key piece, is the sim helps you immensely with your orientation.
Yes.
Everybody has said do the sim for that reason. And you brought up a very key point, is learn how to build the helicopter, because it's great if you have someone build it for you. However, if you don't know how things really work or go together, it's very difficult for you to troubleshoot if you do have a problem with one of the helicopters. Yes. Or something. So that's a key point. What else would you like to tell everybody about yourself?
I would help anybody out. If I'm at any event, I haven't been, for example, to IRCHA. I want to go to my first IRCHA hopefully next year, because, you know, since I got into helicopters, I've been studying for my exams and, you know, preparing myself to apply. Sure. To school. So I haven't had the chance, but hopefully next year, which is when I finish, I'm going to be more active in that aspect. But yeah, just enjoy the hobby, socialize, find a club. That's also very important.
Right.
And, you know, safety is your friend also. I see a lot of people that sometimes they don't know how everything works, and they could be not safe. So I would say safety. Safety is very important.
That's true. And if you're in New York and you're interested in flying helicopters, you can come out to this beautiful field. I mean, you can tell real quick where we're at because I just took the F train.
The F train, yeah.
So where are we at exactly, kind of in relationship to the city?
This is in Brooklyn. We have Coney Island around here. The Verrazano is right in front of us. You just take the Bell Parkway to exit 6, and we're around the area.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's a beautiful field. It's great.
Yes.
Everybody here today was wonderful, so it's good. Well, that's all we have for this session, and we want to say one thing, and that's thanks for flying a line.